Welcome back to Crawdaddy's Custom Crankbaits. We're going to continue working on this bluegill. This will probably be part two of the video. This is where we left off at. What I'm going to do is just take some, really that's like a baby blue ink. Just try to tie in around the gill plate. Bringing it right on down around the chin on the flip gill plate. And when you're doing this color, people do it purple, they do it baby blue, real dark blue. It's entirely up to you. This is just what I choose to do with this light blue. It's just easy and simple. Trying to keep it subtle, not overbearing, just get the tone that you like or the look that you like. Clean your airbrush out real quick. I'm gonna take some black ink. Got this little template here. Just gonna try to lay it up here and do this black ear. If you want to bring it down a little bit on the gill plate, that's fine. It's just whatever you want to try to do. Some people like coming back and putting some white on it. Again, that's entirely what you want to do or how you want to do it. I just ripped a piece of paper to come in here and put my stripes on. Some people like putting them on, some don't. I was going to do this one without it, but I decided to go ahead and just do it just to show you how I do it. I just ripped me a piece of paper. Well, if I pick it up, it don't have to be perfect, but I just find my starting spot and I'm gonna put it right behind the eye. Just gonna come along and these are hard to see, but once you get clear on it, they'll pop. I just try to space it out some. Don't have to be perfect by no means. You want to leave spots in them, that's fine. All I'm trying to do is keep them roughly the same distance apart. While I've got it here, I'm going to go ahead and darken around the eyes just a little bit. some. All it's doing is making it pop a little bit more. Turn it over. Oh, these things are... I started on the back of the eye, so that's what I'm doing here, so that way you know that you're lined up. Like I said, if you want to make these solid, straight lines, you can. If you want to break them, you can. It's all whatever you feel like doing at the time. The key is just try to remember you're getting them all uniformed as best as you can. Hard trying to not block the camera view. working around this eye. I'm just going to come across the back a little bit and just to darken it some. Kind of stay right on the center, just let it overspray, go down the side a little bit. If you want to come back and you want to tone that blue down, just take some thin white. If you want to add some more specks or, you know, random blotches, you know, through the bait, I mean, you can take one of these stencils and just lightly do it. Not trying to do it real dark, just all it's really going to do is pick up some of the scales. That's all you're trying to do. You're just changing that green. I know it's hard to see, but it's actually giving you different scales of different tones. Like I said, if you want it darker, you can make it darker. You can make it as dark as you want to. You can make it as light as you want to. But all I'm doing is come back in and it's just, I'm just adding a little bit more realism, I guess, or texture and life to it. That's all I'm doing. You can keep it in between the black lines if you want to or what, but I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but it just gives scales a little bit different color. Like I said, you can do it, use more yellow if you want it more of a yellowish green. This in here, I'm just trying to keep it a little bit darker. Actually doing this probably from the sun. So this is the way I'm gonna go with this one, but there are so many ways you can paint them. It's entirely up to you. I'm going to try to get in here and darken inside the mouth. Since I've got the black already. I've got the black in the airbrush. What I've done is just put a piece of paper up on this scale and just kind of rubbed it and come back and cut this out, really just mainly for the template that I could put up on top of the scale or on the fins. Just really I want to just mainly do the top edge just a little bit darker. I'll go ahead and clean my airbrush out. I'm gonna darken these top fins. I'm just trying to kind of stay in between the cracks a little bit the best I can. Brush out. And actually, I think I'm going to try to darken this a little bit more. Just try to get them to pop a little bit more. And as I said, if you wanted to come back and add a hint of white up there, you can. It's entirely up to you. I guess that's why I enjoy painting these things, that there is no right, there's no wrong. It's just paint it and enjoy it and have a good time. Take some green ink instead of the moss green, just because it's going to be easier to spray through it. I'm just going to come back in and touch up around the eye if I see any overspray that I want to take care of. All I'm doing is taking some ink going in between the lines just to give it a different tone. I guess I could have done it with this. Just gonna come in here and put some color. Just real lightly. Give the fin some color. This one going gold. Okay, me and the eyeball just don't want to work out tonight. I'm gonna clean my airbrush real quick. Got some of the green. Take care of that. Come back with some pearl white. And we'll spray down the bottom, trying to keep it off the green. And thank you. Stuff don't want to come out of the airbrush. I'm just going to take some orange ink. I'm going to take this off just so I can hold it better and take this orange and just run it on the belly. Let it drift up the side right here in the front a little bit. Right over in the gill plate. Set that down real quick. Just gonna take a little bit of yellow. Letting it bleed up into the orange foam. Really, there you go. There's a bluegill. I mean, like I said, you can change it different tones, how you want to do it. Make it lighter greens, more orangey. You can do whatever color you really want, but that's just a basic way of doing it. And it gives you a really nice brim pattern. Like I said, there's probably 100 ways of doing this bait, color-wise and everything else, but this is just one of the ways I paint them up. Once you clear coat it, you know, you're going to get you a really nice bluegill look. This in here, I just went and added a touch of white to it, and I went more yellow on the bottom on this one, but... that here is this bait here. Once you gloss it, it just gives you a really nice bluegill look. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. I hope you liked it. But that's my bluegill. And like I said, thanks for watching, and please like and share. And from Crawdaddy's, we'll see you next time. Thank you.